up, you guys? It's your favorite girl, Imani Jelena, and I'm back with another video. So before we go ahead and start, don't forget, May at 6 o'clock p.m., I will be having a webinar, and the name of this webinar is Secure 10K in 30-Day Challenge. Tickets are still available. You can get your tickets in the description box. It'll be the very first link for you guys. Don't sleep on this webinar. This webinar is all about budgeting, sales, and so forth. So if you're struggling with sales with your business, this is the webinar you should be at, and I hope to see you there. But as you can see from the title, this video is all about things that make your business look unprofessional. When it comes to professionalism with a business, that is very important because that will decipher if someone will spend money with you or if someone will not spend money with you. It's very important that your business is up to standards and looks good to your customer's eye. So these are just some tips and tricks that I want you guys to avoid when starting your business, or even if you guys have businesses and you notice that some of these key points represent your business, I want you guys to go ahead and make the proper adjustments so that you won't lose out on funds or client or customers. So something that can make your business look unprofessional is going to be your logo. It's very important that your logo has clarity and has a meaning behind it. I see a lot of businesses have logos that in all fairness looks cheap, and that's the representation that your business would then have. So what I would like you guys to do is to make those proper adjustments. Allow logo designers, professional logo designers, to create logos for you, especially if you want to carry your logo for an extensive period of time. And something that I've always mentioned is that you want your logo to have a timeless effect. And what I mean by that is, just because you create a logo this year, you still want it to look good in 5 years from now, or 6 years, or 7 years from now. So it's very important that you have someone who knows exactly what they're doing create a logo for you. And you can find logo designers all over the web, from the actual internet itself, from Instagram, from Facebook, through Snapchat. You can find logo designers anywhere. So it's definitely important that you guys do your research with those and make sure you have an amazing logo that looks good, represents your brand, has a timeless effect to it, and overall is beautiful. The next thing that can potentially make your business look unprofessional is going to be communication. It's very important as a business owner that you have an amazing or outstanding communication. And I know a lot of business owners have, you know, employees that work for them, or people that help you out. You always want to talk to your team to make sure they're giving out excellent communication and excellent service, because that does represent your brand. And no one wants any bad reviews on their business when it comes to communication, because communication is such a small part of the business, and it's a very easy part of the business. And all it requires is just you to be nice, for you to have quality service, and also able to talk to your customers to leave them satisfied. The next thing that could potentially leave your brand looking unprofessional is going to be images. I stress a lot, especially on the people that I mentor or other people in my dropshipping company. And this is going to be a shameless plug. If you guys are interested in joining my dropship services, I'll leave the link in the description box so you can go ahead and sign up to Allure 96's dropship or wholesale. But back to what I was saying about images, it's very important that you have quality images and high resolution images. And the reason I say that is because, for one, if someone comes to your Instagram page or your Facebook page or your website, wherever you're selling these products at, and they see a low quality image, typically that's going to hinder someone from purchasing from you. But let's say they come to your social media platforms or your website and they see a flawless image of someone rocking some curly hair or some straight hair or some wavy hair, that's going to set your company aside and potentially get that customer on board to purchasing from you. So it's very important that you guys do have images. A lot of people contact me regarding stock images. Stock images are important when it comes to your product pages, when it comes to your overall homepage images and the images that your viewers will first see. It's very important that you guys set up some form of photo shoot or some form of product shoot where you are actually showing the product and someone wearing the product. That is very important. The next thing is going to be website. It's very important that you guys have a quality, functional website. A website that is easy to navigate. A website that is just a seamless process from putting something in your cart to the checkout process. Make sure that you guys are thoroughly going through your website and going back into those image phases and making sure that you have quality images up as well. But once again, your website is the final stop to someone purchasing from you. So it's very important that you guys have images, it's descriptions of the products. It's also important that you guys are basically persuading the customer or the person on the opposite end of the phone or computer screen to actually purchasing from you. And something else that I want to throw in there, I was actually speaking with someone, and the lady that I happened to be on the phone with, she was basically saying that she sees people putting things in the cart, but she doesn't actually get the actual sale. And I basically, when I was mentoring her, I basically just went ahead and went through the process where I actually purchased something from her website. And that's what I want you guys to do. Because, for instance, with this situation, people were adding things to their cart, but the person who I was mentoring, did not have the proper setup for people to purchase from her. And she didn't have her payment processors aligned so that people can actually make a purchase. So people would get to checkout and notice that they can't actually make a purchase and move on. So basically, I want you guys to do that same thing. I want you guys to actually go to your website, put something in your cart, and make sure that it's a smooth process all the way to checkout, and make sure there is no errors through the actual checkout process. So the next thing is going to be social media activity. You always want to make sure that you're engaging with those who are engaging with you. If you guys have been watching my videos for a while, you would know that I like to say show up for the people who show up for you. So make sure you guys are doing that. Don't ignore the people who are actually interested in your product. Don't ignore the people who are actually putting you in their story on Instagram or commenting under your post under your business page. So it's very important that you guys are actually acknowledging the people who are there for you. And then the very last thing is going to be the public appearance. As an owner, it's very important that you're putting out a positive persona, a positive image about you, because you reflect your brand. So always make sure as an owner that you are always putting out things that you would look back on and be proud, because that will make your brand look professional, and it'll also make people purchase from you. Because as you guys know, people don't purchase the actual product, people purchase you. So if you're putting out an image that you are professional, an image that you are someone that your clientele or customers can trust, people will 9 times out of 10 purchase from you because they trust what you're putting out there and they trust your brand. So from all of this information in this video, I want you guys to make the best decisions that you can possibly make for your business, especially if this is something that you genuinely want to do. If you are opening a business just because this is the cool thing to do, or if just because this is the cool thing to do this summer, your business is not going to thrive. But if you're someone that is ready to put the blood, sweat, and tears behind your business, I can guarantee that you will have much success, especially if you continue to do research, continue to implement amazing ideas into your business, and put a professional image out there. Your business has no choice but to thrive and to grow. So, like I said, don't forget, May 25th at 6 o'clock p.m., I will be having a webinar. I hope to see all of you guys there. And if you guys don't know, it's the Secure 10K in 30 Day webinar. This webinar is all about sales and budgeting. If you guys are interested, the link is right in the description box, the very first link in the description box. I hope to see all of you guys there. I love you guys, and leave me some comments below, because I do enjoy interacting with you guys. But I will see you guys in my next video, and I will talk to you later. Bye.